Okay, chapter 5 is recursion. Okay, there is a more question on recursion. Okay, you must understand what is recursion. Okay, what is recursion? Huh? What is recursion? Call itself. Okay, it's a method that call itself. It's a function that call itself. If it call itself, that's a recursion. But if the recursion only call itself, is that really good recursion? Every recursion must have anchor. Otherwise, it recursive call infinitely. We don't want them to recursive call infinitely. We want them to stop. We're going to make anchor to make sure at a certain point, if something, it's going to stop. Don't make recursive call. Give me example of recursive algorithm that we have seen. Factorial? Fibonacci? Huh? Exponential? What you just seen a couple of weeks ago? Huh? Heap? Do we have recursion in heap? Huh? Mook? Huh? Fibonacci? Okay. Fibonacci? Actually, Fibonacci. Quick sort make recursion. And also, merge sort also recursion. Okay? Okay, so you must know all this, okay? That's chapter 5. Chapter 6, 3. What will be in exam 3? You must know from beginning what you have learned in the 3. Breadford, okay, 3 traversal. Okay, will be in exam, study 3 traversal. Breadford, depth first. In term of depth first, we have 3 of them. Pre-order, in-order, and post-order. Okay, know how to do them. Know how to write code. Write code too. There are many questions. You have to write Java. You have to know 3, how to write a code to insert node into a tree, insert value into a tree. The tree you can insert, what else? You can traverse, you can insert, you can delete. Okay. You must know how to do this. What else I can do with a tree? Delete, there are two kinds. What are two delete? Delete by? Hey, by what? Delete by merging. We have to study it. Delete by merging and delete by copying. Okay, one of these delete technique is in the exam. Okay, delete by merging or delete by copying. You must know them. What else you learn? Balancing the tree. Okay, what do we make? We learn. We make, like, remember backbone and try to rotate. Okay, that one way to balance. Or is another one? Remember AVL? What is AVL? The every tree, every node must have balance factor. You keep balance factor between what? Balance factor must be between minus 1, 0, or 1. If it beyond that, you're gonna rotate. maybe single rotate or double rotate. Okay, remember? Can you do that? Balance the tree. Balance the tree. Probably not in the exam. Probably, I'm not sure. Probably not. What else you learn the tree? Heap. Heap is in the exam. Court or do the heap? I don't remember. I don't remember, but I remember there is one page of your exam talk about heap. I'm not sure, right court or transform array into heap, maybe. Or maybe insert value into a tree to make it a heap. Let's say you have empty tree. I give you a list of number. Can you make a new tree with that list of value? Make sure the tree is going to be heap. Okay. Or another way, I give you a tree that non-heap. You transform it into the heap. Okay. Okay, what else you learn? In binary tree. Move down. Okay, sort. What did we learn? Sort. Selection. Insertion. Bubble. One of these three. Among those sorting algorithms, all of them, I'm going to give you a number and ask you to show me how to sort. You have to know all of them. Okay, how to sort. How to you show me the numbers. Okay. All of them, selection, insertion, bubble, what else? Quick sort, tail sort, merge sort, radix sort, and heap sort. Okay. I think one of them is not in the exam. I remember heap sort is not in the exam. Heap probably not in the exam. But the rest of those seven, you must know them how to sort. Okay. Among three of the insertion, selection, bubble, you have to write code. Insert, select, insertion, selection, bubble, sort. Among the three sort algorithm, you must write Java, write code. But for the quick merge, either quick or merge, you have to write code. Because I already showed you in the lab. Either quick sort or merge sort, you have to write Java. But to trace the data, the numbers, you have to know them all, except heap sort. Okay? What else we learn? Huh? What did we learn before compression? Yesterday. Hash. Hash is in the exam. Okay? You must know the hash. How to insert value into the hash. Insert value into the table of the hash. Okay? It depends on the hash function, right? And when it's collide, we have many ways to solve, remember? We can use linear probing, quadratic probing, remember? Chain, good. Okay, bucket. Okay, so learn all this, it will be an exam. Okay. Yesterday, what did we learn about hash? Chicheli method, remember? To make a perfect hash. Okay, Chicheli method is not in the exam. Oh, you want it? I can add it. I just submit the exam today. I can add more if you like. Okay, and today this one is in the exam. Huffman code. Okay. Understand everything? Hey, any question? Huh? All right. I see you on 11. They make exam is at 9 o'clock in the morning. Okay. Oh, one more thing. PN, can I see that score? Oh, it is the one? Okay, we haven't posted your score. We forgot. Hey, Chan Phan Thai is here. Not yet. How come he come late? Oi. Here is your score. Okay. Sorry that we haven't posted. We will post. I haven't posted. Oh, gonna find out. Most of you missing lab because you didn't email to P and I saw all the time. I warned you 1,000 times. Okay, if you have the lab and you have an email, email PN after this, okay? Okay, at the same time, you can look at the quiz also. Ah, 1 to 15, you see your score? It's a lab, you're missing lab, okay? If you know that you did the lab and PN hasn't received, email her again. I don't know who it is, 14 person. Attendant, you don't like it. Hey, we don't have score for attendant. All right, the lab is the lab not attendant. You have to mail us the lab. Some of you may miss homework, okay? Try to do it, okay? The quiz, you cannot do anything about it. The quiz is bad, it's bad. But the homework, you can still send to PN, okay? Okay, it is 1 to 15, next batch. 17 to 33. I will post this file over the classroom on demand, okay? Sorry that we haven't posted. You should post long time ago. Okay? Again, if you haven't sent any of this, you can send to PN, okay? It's our fault that we haven't posted this one. Can I move? I we will post this one on the classroom on demand. Okay, don't worry. You can check from the website. From the 35 down to 50. เขาไม่ได้ทำอ่ะ
ห้องที
่
สองผิดอันไหนครับ
ไม่รู้ทำไม่ได้
ม
ี
ค
ิ
ดในคาน
อันหนึ่งคนหนึ่งมีศูนย์คนหนึ่งมียี่ห้าเลย
ฮะยี่ห้าไหน
เขาต้องได้สองอาจารย์มีสองงงมากคะแนนดูห่างไปนะ
เขาทำได้หรือเปล่าโอเคlast นี่50 last person โอเค
กูเห็นคนอ
ื่
นแม่ง
ได้1
2
3 4 5 6 7 8 9
10 11 12 13 14 15 16 17 18 19 20 21 22
23 21 22 VPN will check for you okay
okay.
PN will recheck for this person. Okay, like I told you, okay? The name of the subject is important. Sometimes PN see the subject for lab 10, for example. Let's say you intend for lab 11, but you write lab 10. Then PN will not check for lab 11, check for lab 10. Okay? Make sure you email to PN, okay? That's the work. And also, your midterm. This is your midterm after the makeup. This is midterm, a revised midterm. This is after we combine with your makeup test. Okay? All right, let's do a midterm. Okay, all right, I have to go. Ajahn Pornchai probably waiting right now. I will post this file, okay? So if somebody score you are not agree with, talk to me and PN, okay? All right, we have to go, sorry. ID เบอร์อะไร ID คุณหรือเปล่าOkay. All right, we have to go.All right, Ajahn Pornchai is waiting. We have to go.
Okay. Exam. Okay, exam. Let's see. The final exam. Okay, so I uploaded the details. The detail of your upcoming exam. Okay, you can check the details from your website. Okay. Yeah. Exam. Your exam will be on the very last day. No, very last day. So take it easy. Okay. You still have lots of time, yeah, to prepare for the final exam on May 19th. Okay, May 19th. Possibly the last subject, yeah, in the evening. No, in the afternoon, 1 to 4 o'clock. Okay, right there, 2:06. Okay. Okay. Criterias here. Okay. Closed book and closed notes. Okay. No notes. No any kind of notes. No slides. Okay. You cannot bring in any papers. Okay. No sheets. Okay. No textbooks. Okay. That's it, right? However, you can bring in here. You are allowed to bring in a paper-based dictionary, just one copy. That's enough. Just in case you need to look up for the meanings. Okay. If you don't want, if you don't need, you don't have to bring in any text-based, paper-based dictionary. Okay. Also, you can bring in one calculator. Okay. This time, you need to use the helper, the calculator. Okay. Very simple one. Okay. You can just one, okay, none. One. You cannot use any smartphones, smart watch. Well, basically you should not bring in and use any internet connected device. Okay. Right. So if your calculator can connect to the internet, right, we will cease. We will take away that calculator. So very simple. Okay. No connection. No Wi-Fi, no Bluetooth, whatever, right? No connection calculator, okay? Just one. Okay, you need to use square root. Okay, at least I'm sure most calculators, even the simplest one, would support the functions like square root, square and fraction. Something like that. So just bring one, okay? Okay, right. So that's it, right? And then pen and pencils, erasers, and that's all you need. Okay. Exam. This time has the total of 9 questions. 9 questions. Okay. 9 main or 9 big questions, and there are some sub questions. Yeah, there could be 1, 2, or 3, or 4, okay, smaller questions inside each main questions. Okay, but the sub questions are mostly related to one another. Okay, so same issue. And okay, exam has, I will put the total marks, the maximum marks that you could get along with each sub questions. Okay, at each small question, I will put the marks, the points basically that you can earn if you fulfill the the questions. And okay, so if you add all the points or marks, right, from those 9 questions, the total points are 52. Not much. Okay. And I need to convert this one into 35%. Okay. So again, this is just 1% is close to what? About 1 point something, no more than 2 marks. Okay, for 1%. So that's a lot, right? So 1 mark is worth a lot. Okay, so if you miss just 1 mark, that's you could be in big trouble, okay, when you add all your earned marks to the final grade. Okay, the final grade is worth 100%. And the final exam is already worth up to 35% up to. You can earn up to this much here. Okay. Okay, so 1 point is worth a lot. Okay, so read the questions carefully. Now. And each question is worth at least 1 point anyway. So you need to answer all the questions. Do not leave any blank answers. Okay, most in the midterm exam, some of you are left out, empty answers, no answer at all. So I cannot give you any credits, any points. But if you try to answer something, I will give you something for sure. Okay. Just say something, just show that you understand the question. Even though it's not correct, I still give you some points. Okay. And that's it. And you need to write down your solution answers all on the question sheets. Okay. Just in that the exams sheet. Okay. Not I don't have any separate answer books. Okay, just write down on the one that you have. Yeah, that's it. Yeah. And if you need more space, more spaces, you can refer my reading to the back of each page, each sheet. Right. So, but put some note. Okay, put or draw some the directional arrows so I know what it is. Okay. That's it. Any question about the exam? Okay. Today, yeah. Okay. So today, agenda today, right? Hopefully we get it done by 5 o'clock. Okay. I will go over all the materials that you are supposed to re-study, to read, okay, for your exam. I will point to you which section or which areas that you should read. Prepare for your exam, okay. And okay, by the way, the solutions I uploaded all the solutions, all the exercises that I asked you in classes, right? Already up there. Okay, so you check. So most of them are. I mean, all of them are correct because I check with the answers from the textbooks. Okay, so most are correct, and then I double check. So those are correct. So just follow the solutions that I provided you. Okay. Okay, on Friday is the last. Okay, you need to come here. We have one more class. Okay, by the way, on Friday. Okay. No more lecture, but simply doing some programming, very simple programming. Okay. I I already asked one of my students get to graduate student show you the some techniques on using R programming in analysis in the clustering and so on. So, yeah. Okay, and I will demonstrate the ways to do the linear regressions. Okay, so those are topics, two topics that we will learn and do on Friday. Okay, no materials from the textbook. Friday. Okay. Okay. Friday is we will meet at training room number 1, same time, 10 o'clock. Yeah. Okay. Here are all the solutions online. Okay. So, and we have. We have 5 chapters to cover. For your final exam, chapter 5, starting from chapter 5 to chapter 9. Okay, so right, so we have 9 questions, right? So at least each chapter contributes at least 1 question for the exam. Okay. Some chapters have more than 1 questions, could be 2 or 3. Okay, so every chapters 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, okay, you need to study all those 5 chapters. Okay, so first I will go over each chapter. Okay, let's working backward from chapter 9, okay, down to chapter 5. Okay, let's see chapter 9 here. Okay, simple linear regressions. At least 1 question. There could be 2 questions from this chapter. Okay, we did not do much. Okay, from this chapter. Okay, however, we learn how to to check if there is any linear. Okay, I emphasize linear relationship models. Okay, right, linear relationship between variables. Yeah, and then by using formulas. Okay, by the way, all the formulas, as I told you previously, formula will be given, okay, as well as all the needed tables. We have so many tables. Okay, you see score or normal distribution table, T students T tables. F table, right? ANOVA F test table, F tables, chi square table, and what else? What else? That's it, right? Okay, at least 4 tables. Okay, they are all given. Okay, and all the needed formulas. But we will not tell you which formula is used for which purpose. Okay, I just simply throw in all the formulas for you. Okay, so you need to choose the correct one yourself. Okay, so you need to use which formula should be used for proportions, from means comparison. For what? For small sample size, which one is used for large sampling, something like that. So I may not give you all the details, you need to I assume you need to know them yourself but you don't need to memorize yeah the formulas okay okay this chapter okay so let's say mostly okay quickly point to you okay so something like this okay right so variables okay so first you need to be able to plot the data points okay and you need to be able to draw something draw a line okay this question is about the linear model yeah linear regressions yeah so draw a line don't use a curve yeah should not draw the curve like this I don't want that line simple okay very simple okay like this okay oh by the way okay question may ask you about range okay you know range right the scope or range of variables values of the data points okay range here from here right range of runs from 1 right x equals 1 to x equals 5 right here okay right 5 1 right so anything outside this is unknown okay we have no idea about this area here no idea about this yeah area here beyond the scope beyond the range so you should not okay if the question asks you to make some inferences, make some conclusion. You just be clear, okay? About yeah, that about being able to say only in this range and nothing else. Okay. And again, this represents the linear relationship. Okay. One of your exercises. Okay. Ask about you know as if this kind of relationship okay is causal or not causal okay there's a term here okay causal or cause and effect. Okay, causal. Okay. The linear, this just be a linear. There seems to be some correlation, right? Remember we have R. Right, R. We use R to represent correlation. And we have R square represent the determination. Okay. Again, in the exam, we ask you R square correlation determination. Okay. And then we ask you about a linear relationship and not causal. Cause and effect or causal relationships. This is more somehow this one okay. This is stronger relationship between variables. Okay. But this one the linear relationship is weaker. Okay. And so when you see something like this, some of this may not have this causal or cause effect relationship okay some may do some may not right so be clear about that okay different terms okay like that okay you can read the homework solutions the exercise solutions okay something like that okay and here okay you need to know about this Okay, this all these terms here, all these symbols. Okay, I use okay beta 0, beta 1, just like this. I use x, I use y. Okay, so you should know what beta 1 is. I hope you know. Okay, slope. Epsilon is a random error. Okay, because it's just an approximation. Approximation, right? Sometimes you cannot find the line that passes through all the points. So you need to have this one for sure. Yeah. Epsilon. Okay. And beta 0. Beta 0 is the y-intercept, right? The distance on the y-axis from the origin. 0, 0. Okay, the something like this. Okay. Okay. And question may ask you the meaning of beta 0, beta 1. What do they represent? So when you have some values, what does it mean? You need to answer that too. Okay. Right. Okay. Okay, the formula again will be given. Okay, like that. Okay, and yeah. Okay, so you should be able to look at the beta one slope. Okay, and knowing about psi of relationship, right? Knowing, yeah. Being positive, negative, or not related or no relationship. Okay, right. So this is a no relationship, constant, simply constant line. Okay, this is a decreasing, increasing, positive. Okay, you can look at beta 1 and you can say that, okay, based on, okay. And also, this one, okay, just like in your exercise, I may ask you this in the exam, how you can set up the hypothesis testing. So you should know, what do we test here? Okay, why we use this now hypothesis, alternative hypothesis. What does it mean here? Okay, if you don't, okay, what does it mean here? Can you say something about this? Okay, beta 0. What does it mean here? Okay, beta 1 equal to 0. Beta 1 less than 0. What do we try to test here? Okay, in this case, what do we try? What do we test in this case here? Huh? Can someone tell me what do we test? If we have this hypothesis, huh? What do we test? We want to check if what? If we should not use beta 1. We want to check if, you know, the relationship, okay, if there is any relationship, right, and if there is, okay, check if the relationship is negative or not. Okay, right. So your friend just said beta 1, right? Beta 1 is just a it's too specific, right? So we want to say more in general that we want to test if there is any kind of negative relationship between variables, two variables. Okay, by linear, by variables, okay, x and y, okay. So this is when you test, okay. When you see something like this, test if there is any positive linear relationship between x and y. Okay, right. So you should be able to say that. Okay, in explaining the hypothesis. And you can reject or not reject. Okay, and here you see this one T. It is the T's students T statistic using the T table. Okay, and using T tables, you need to know the degrees of freedom. And here it is, right there. Okay. N-2, okay, N-2, okay, not 1, okay, and then you can check the condition for judging rejection region, okay, using this one. Okay, so basically, know how to use this one, okay, understand this, very simple, okay, but understand what it means, okay. Okay. And next one, CC, coefficient of correlation, R. Okay. You should know what it is, how to compute. Okay. Formula will be given, but you need to explain. Okay. And also, last one from this chapter, the CD, coefficient of determination. Okay, determination. Okay, so again, read the. You can Google online and see what does it mean. What the coefficient of determination means. Okay, so basically, I can say that it represents how much x variables contributes. Information of predicting y variables. Okay, right. That's what it means. But you can check now. Look up for more information from the website. Okay, and see that. Okay, so this is a R square. Right. So if I know correlation, I can simply figure out the CD easily. If I know CD, I can take square root. And figure out correlation. Okay, and you should know the range, right? Range of this CD between 0 and 1. R, CC, the range is from -1 to 1. Okay, not the same range, okay, due to the square. Okay, so you should know what it is here, okay? So again, you should know this one, okay? And that's it, okay, that's it for this chapter, okay? So at least you would get one question, and if you prepare, you should get 2 marks for this chapter. Okay, easily. Okay, I guarantee you. Okay. Okay, the prior. Chapter, okay. Chapter 8. Let me see. Chapter 8. Okay, we work downward here. Okay. Comparing the proportions. Okay. P. We use P. Symbol P. Right. Proportions or percentage. Percentage. Okay. We compare. Yeah, compare. Okay. It could be between 2 sample populations, or could be 3 or more. Okay. Like this. And then we have, you know. Here, this chapter, if you think back, we talk about chi square. Right, didn't we? Chi square. Right, we have 1 tables. We have 1-way table. We have 2-ways table. Okay, just think about that, okay? And your last exercise is basically is 2-way tables. K Okay, last time we mentioned that in class, and I thought it should be one way, right? But in fact, you can use two ways to solve that problems. Okay, look up the solution I gave you. Okay. Okay, so this chapter. Okay, let's see. We want to compare. Okay, compare. This mean you want to check if they are the same or not. Okay. Or if they are equal to what the values are given. Okay. So sometimes all the values are not the same, but we want to check if they are the same. If they follow the value that they are supposed to be. Okay. So let's see here. So here you would have at least one question here. Okay. Let's move quickly here. Okay. So this chapter chi-square. So chi-square table will be given. So you should know how to use the table. You should know how to use the formula. Okay. And then we have here one way and two ways. Okay. I'm not quite sure which one I asked you. Okay, but they are not that difficult anyway. Okay. Just punch in the number. Okay, so let's see here. Okay, so for us to use the table, okay, the one-way table, two-way tables, chi-square, we need to compute the expected values, the mean or the expected values. Okay, we use the symbol E, capital letter E, represent the expected values, and the value, the formula of E, okay? Oh, you see later. Okay, can be computed. Okay. Let's move on quickly. Oh, all the way down. Oh, not even here. So let me jump to the work backward, okay. Okay, let's move on. Okay, this one here. The multinomial experiment. Okay, multinomials. Okay, similar to binomial. Okay, but binomial requires or has only two possible outcomes. Okay, but multinomials, yeah, three or more possible outcomes. Okay, or more, three or more groups. Okay, so starting from this one here. Okay, and we can compute. The expected value. Okay, like this. Okay, this is a hypothesis setting. Now alternative. Okay, this we compare, right? We compare the proportions P1, P2, P3. They all represent the proportions. Proportion can be the same here, or could be different. Doesn't matter, depending on the question. Okay, and alternative is at least one of the proportions differs from what are given. Okay, so even you try to understand what we mean here. Okay. And then you need to compute the expected values. Okay. Simply, this one simply multiply this one to n. You will see the formula later. Formula later. Okay. And then this is the formula to compute chi square. Okay. And the formula is given like this. Later here. Okay. This one here. One way table. Okay, understand E there, okay? Like that. And then we use chi square. When you see something like this, yeah, square x, yeah, x square, chi square. Okay. And you compute, and then you compare to, okay, by the way, chi square also requires the degree of freedom. Okay, you need to, you need to know the degree of freedom. I think I may give you this one, the degree of freedoms. Okay. So you, if I don't give you, you may forget what it is. Okay. Okay. So just know how to use this. Okay. For one way table. Okay. And yeah, make some conclusion. Okay. Okay. This is a one way where the proportions are not the same here. Not the same, not the same, not the same. But at least one differs. Okay. Or it could be the same, could not be the same. Okay, this is another example. You can use chi-square and check the rejection region. Okay. Move on to the two-way table. Okay. By the way, the proportions, just like in this chapter, you need to use the qualitative variables. Qualitative variables. Those variables outcome or values could not assume or could not have numerical scales values. Yeah. Okay. That's why we call them qualitative variables. You can only label them A, B, C, D, okay, something like that. Okay. So two-way table, not that much difficult. Okay, you just say your last exercise. Okay, you do something like this: create the tables, fill in the sales data, total things up. Okay, like this, we call this contingency tables as well, two ways. Okay, and these are formulas that you need to use. Okay. E again, expected values, but there's different ways to compute the values, and use the same table, chi-square table, but different degrees of freedom now. I will give you again this one, degree of freedom. So you need this to look up the table, to get the chi-square, and then compare the chi-square. This is chi-square from what? From your experiment, this one, okay, and this one is a chi-square from the table. When you are given this confidence level, now, given this alpha is the significant level, okay, not confident level. If you have 1 minus alpha, that would be the confidence level. Alpha is the significant level. Okay, so you compare the one that you have here, compare to the tables, the one that you have from the table, and then make decisions to reject this or not to reject this one. Okay, right. Okay, that's okay. So one way, two way. Now, some more from this table. Okay, so when you compare. Okay, you can compare. Okay, you can have. Okay, when you do some samples. Okay, and that samples are independent. Okay, you can also compare to sample proportions. Okay, by checking the test like this. Okay, this one here. Okay, this is similar to the previous chapters. Okay, instead of using mean, we use proportions. Okay, here we use P1, P2 compare if they are the same. Okay, when you see this one, okay, P1 minus P2, this is the difference. And then if you set the difference to be 0, that means P1 is equal to P2. So we check if, you know, these two independent samples have the same proportion or not. Okay. And alternative, it could be less than, it could be larger than, could be not equal. Okay. Okay, and test statistic, when you have large here, you should use Z, standard Z scores, with this formula. Okay. And P1 hat, P2 hat represent the sample proportion. Okay. And this one can be computed using this formula here. Okay. Even better here. So they are all given to you. All this, right? And just plug in and then make conclusion. Okay, based on your setting. So make sure that you can you should understand how to set up the hypothesis. The noun must be only equal sign. Okay. Must be equal sign always, okay? But the alternative can be less than, larger than, or not equal. Depending on the question. Some question may ask you to check, to test less than sign. Some question may check larger than sign, or unequal. But the alternative must, but the noun must be zero. Okay. Yeah, for this, this cause, okay, cannot be anything else. Okay, so you may need this one, okay, for your exam. Okay, this is the same thing here. Some more example like that. Okay, size. I don't ask you anything about size. Because you can compute size easily, okay, based on the formula. Okay, so I think that I better ask you something else about hypothesis and some inferences. So I don't care about size. Okay, so you can skip. It will be nice if you read this one, but you don't have to about size. Okay, so no question asking about size at all for your final exams. Okay, not from any chapters. Okay, but the size here, you may need this one. You may need formula to compute size when you do some experiment in your future study. Okay, so let's say you want to run some experiment. Making some surveys, right? You want to know how much or how many people, how many subjects that you need to survey, you need to ask. You don't know the size, okay, but you know some confidence. So you need to use that to compute the size using formula like this. Okay. But in the exam, no question about the size. Okay. So move on. Okay. Okay, that's it. Okay, all right. Chapter 8. Question. Okay, so we will compare proportions, one-way table, two-way table, chi-square. Know how to use the table, and be able to explain the hypothesis testing. Okay, move on. Okay, back to chapter 7. Chapter 7 where? Okay, here. Okay. Chapter 8, okay, we compare the proportions, right, of the qualitative variables. This chapter 7, we compare the quantitative variables, quantity, right? The variables that can be represented using numerical scales, using the numbers, not the label. Okay. For example, age could be what? Could be number 10 years old, could be 20, could be 30.5, something like that, right? So this is why you need to use the means value, the mean, not proportion. Okay, so we want to compare the means here. Let's say compare average GPA from one university, compare it to another university. You compare means, okay? So like this. So we need to use some formula. Okay, yeah. Not that difficult, the formula, okay? Okay, this, by the way, so you need this formula here to compute the standard deviation. Okay. By the way, you can compute, okay, you need to assume the independent samples. Okay, let's say here compared to populations, right? Okay, each population when you sample, the samples must be independent. What does it mean? Let's say you have two groups here. This population one, population two. When I sample, I need to do the random sample from here and from there. Okay. And each population has no effect or no influence on the other one. No kind of dependencies. Okay. If not, okay, it must be independent. If not, you cannot use this formula. Okay, you need to use something else. For example, you might use pair difference. Okay, in that case. Okay, let's see. Okay, let's say first assume independent samples. Okay, here. Okay. And we can use a large sample based on the statistic, or we can use small sample based on the T statistic. Okay. Being large, that means the size is larger than 30 or more. Okay, 30 or more, being large. Okay. Smaller, that means under 30. Okay, so okay, this is the CI. We will talk more about CI in chapter 5. Okay, but here when you set up the hypothesis like this, okay, you compare, right? When you compare, you need to set up the hypothesis. Similar looks to previous chapters. When you set up hypothesis, again, the null or zero here. The noun must be used for equal sign. The alternative can support less than, larger than, or not equal. Okay. Now we have only two, right? Two populations. You can use mu one, mu two. And we want to see if they are the same. So if they are the same, the difference must be zero. Right? So normally the difference is said to be zero. And we check if they are the same. Okay. Yeah, we put a note here. Okay, and then we follow these formulas. Okay, just plug in here. Okay, and then you do some checking based on the Z table. Look up the table. Okay. Okay. You see here, right? The mean compared between these two universities, larger than 30, larger than 30. So you use Z score. Okay, move on here. Okay, keep on going. Okay, for the small sample size, okay, you use T statistic. Very similar formula, but different tables. Okay, the same way as offsetting the hypothesis. Okay, and you check that. You need to know the degree of freedom. Okay, and because we compare two populations from two samples, the degree of freedom is this one here, N1 plus N2 minus 2. Okay. I'll give you this formula. Okay. Yeah, that's it, right? Okay. Now move on here. Okay. Keep on going there. Okay. Okay. Now. Now. Okay. What happened? Okay. If the samples could not be independent. Okay. Previously, I said that two samples, okay, from two groups, right, must be independent. No influence, no effect on each other. Okay. But in real life, in some practical problems, you use the same groups of people, right? Pre-test and post-test, for example, the same group, right? But you do it twice. You do something, experiment before learning something, and you compute the mean, and then you let the same group of people learn something, do something, and then you run the survey again, you run the test. Somehow there could be some dependency between pre-test and post-test of the same group. So in that case, we cannot use the previous approach. We need to use this approach, the pair difference experiments. Okay. I believe I asked you one question in the exam. Okay, so you need to understand this. Okay, just read examples. Okay. So how do we do this? Yeah, just list out two populations or two samples. Yeah. Which could be, which depends on somehow, not independence. Okay, like this, new and old. Okay, all group one, group two, and then find the difference. Just like the name said right here, pair difference. So you find it different pair by pair, like this. Okay, and then follow the formula. Okay. Yeah, I emphasize not independent. Okay, and then follow this one. Okay. And use this T statistic. Okay, using the T table for pair difference. Because it can support smaller size and larger size. Because sometimes you compare only what 10 people under 30, right? So T makes sense, not Z. So you use here, right? Okay. So follow this formula. Oh, okay, by the way, okay. Okay, if you have larger samples, you can use Z. Okay. So, okay. But for smaller size, using T. And, yeah. And this is degree of freedoms. And you can set up the test, okay, for pair difference. Okay, this is for large sample size. Okay, just for this one. Okay, now, what else do we need to know? Okay, some more example there. Okay, just move on. Okay, keep on going. Okay, again, no worry about the size. I didn't ask you about the size, sample size. Okay, nothing about Will Coxon. No worry about this one. We don't learn this. It's too much. Okay, so skip this one. No worry about this. Okay, this is too much there. Okay. Keep going. Okay. Okay, no worry about that. Okay. Okay, now this part here, I ask you at least one question. Okay, F test. We call this analysis of variance, ANOVA F test, using the F distribution table. So I give you again, I give you the tables, the formula. Okay, in this time, okay, we want to compare three or more, not two. Okay, if you have only two populations, you use the previous approach. But if you have three or more means to compare, you better use this approach here. It's better. Okay, then we call this ANOVA. Okay, F test. Yeah, F test. Okay. You need to compute errors. MST, MSE, something like that. Okay, like this one here. Okay, you can set up. Okay, set up the formula like this. Set up the hypothesis like this. Okay, here, right? Then now, all equals must be three or more. And then the alternative, at least two, differs. Okay, to compute, these are formulas needed. Okay, here. They will be given. Okay, eventually you need to compute this one, the F values. Okay, from here. And compare that against the one from the table. Compare, okay? Compare against the table. The table, you need to use alpha. Alpha will be given in the exam. Okay, and then look up and then, okay. This time, F table, you need to use two. There are two types of degrees of freedoms. Two types of DF, V1, V2, okay, numerator, denominators, so something like that, okay. So you should know, I think I will give you again, V1, V2, okay. But you should know how to compute, you should know what K is. I will not tell you, okay, I guess I will not tell you K. You should know what K, yeah, read the slides. Okay, compute this. Okay. And that's it for this chapter. Okay. Question about this chapter? Chapter 7. Okay, about the means. Chapter 8 about the proportions. Chapter 9, linear regressions. So far, three chapters. Okay, two more chapters. Chapter 6, very simple. Chapter 6, okay, here. About how to set up hypotheses. Okay, we already talked about this in chapter 9, chapter 8, chapter 7 already. Hypotheses. So this one is just an introduction to later chapters on hypotheses, right? So I guess I don't need to say much about this. In the exam, you need to be able to set up hypotheses. Now, alternative, according to the question asking you. Okay. So, right. So nothing to say much here. Very simple, right? To say that. Okay, I have lots of examples here. Okay, examples. Okay, not that bad there. Okay, now hypothesis, alternative. You need to read this and understand. Okay. Okay. Like that. Okay. The formula. This is only one population. Only one mu. So the formula is very simple. Like this. Okay. will be given. Okay, and one more topic about this chapter is the p-values. P-value where? Okay, let's move on. Okay, so you need to read all this stuff. Okay, now here. Okay, in your exercises, okay, lots of questions were related to p-values somehow. Okay, and in the exam, you will see the term that is p-values. So I want to make it clear, okay, what it is. Okay, so first, let me ask you, what do you understand about p-values? What is it? What is it? The p-value. The p-value. Huh? The, just like this one here. The observed, okay, just memorize this here. Observed significant levels. That's all you need to know. Very simple, right? So basically, p-value is the same thing as the alpha values. But this alpha is from where? Alpha from the experiment. Experiment or from survey, whatever. The one that you do samples, and then you compute the mean proportion or whatever, and then you get the values. Okay, and the value is the alpha. Okay, and this is called the observed. Okay, sometimes we call this observed alpha. And we call this p-value. Okay. So what is the alpha? Alpha is the significant levels. Okay. So when you have something like this, I hope you can see this here, right? Here. Okay. And then you have alpha. Okay. This is alpha. This is the alpha, right? Alpha is the significant levels. Alpha, okay, so there are two alphas. Alpha from the question given. Okay, question may give you the alpha. Let's say alpha equals 0.05. What does it mean? 5% alpha. So the confidence level is 95%. Right, so this is given by the questions. Or when you look up the tables, you need to use the alpha. Right? Alpha. So those are alpha from the predefined. Could be alpha, could be 0.05, could be 0.01, could be 0.1. We don't know a lot of alphas. But those alpha are from, these are predefined alpha. Or these are given alpha. Okay. Not the same thing as this alpha. Alpha is, this one is from your experiment, from your sample, when you do the test. They may not be the same thing. Most likely, they will not be the same thing. They're not the same values. So that's why you need to compare. You need to compare this one to this one. Okay? They are not the same values, most likely. You compare this to that. And okay, let's say here, this is, I call this alpha, okay? And if I call this alpha star,